Bismillah ar-Rahman ar-Rahim. All praise and thanks is due to Allah, the Lord of the Universe. And we send peace and salutations to the Prophet Muhammad, to his household and to the companions. To proceed, brothers and sisters, as we know, we are in the first 10 days of Dhul-Hijjah, today being the third. About these days, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says in the Quran, وَالْفَجْرِ وَلَيَالٍ عَشْرٍ. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, He takes an oath upon the time of dawn, the Fajr, and Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala takes an oath upon these last 10, these first 10 days of Dhul-Hijjah. Ibn Abbas radiallahu anhuma, and majority of the Mufassirun are of the opinion that this Layal Ashr are the first 10 days of Dhul-Hijjah. The Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam also says regarding this, ما من أيام العمل الصالح فيهن أحب إلى الله من هذه العشر قالوا ولا الجهاد في سبيل الله يا رسول الله قال ولا الجهاد في سبيل الله إلا رجل خرج بنفسه وماله ولم يرجع من ذلك بشيء أو كما قال صلى الله عليه وسلم. The hadith is reported, the hadith is narrated by At-Tirmidhi, where the Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم says that there are no days in which deeds, the good deeds, are more beloved to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala than these first 10 days of Dhul-Hijjah. And they said, Ya Rasulullah, even a person who strives in the way of Allah. And he said, even a person who strives in the way of Allah, except that who dies as a shaheed in the battlefield. Understanding from this hadith, brothers and sisters, as we build from this, is that these 10 days are a blessed time that we don't have the opportunity, we can't afford to lose these 10 days. Work hard as much as possible to do whatever khair that you can do in these 10 days. Brothers and sisters, our time in this world is so limited, and we don't know, we are not guaranteed tomorrow. Right now we have the chance to do the khairat, we have the chance to do the good deeds. Tomorrow when we pass away, everyone passes away regretting whether he was a good person or an evil doer. The good person will regret because they would like to increase for what they had done in good, and the evil person would regret because they did not take opportunity, or they did not follow the guidance. Allahu musta'an. Brothers and sisters, so we advise each other and we encourage each other in these 10 days that we carry out good deeds, such as reading the Quran. Try to finish the Quran in these 10 days if you are able to. If you're not able to, try to, you know, have a portion that you stick to, inshallah, and you recite and you ponder over, and even if you can get a teacher who corrects your mistakes on the, you know, on your recitation or the way you read the ayah, do so, and have the intention that this is only for Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, and Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala reward you for your intention and your deed. And then also, brothers and sisters, doing a lot of dhikr is also emphasized in these days. It is Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says in the Quran, doing a dhikr in these days for the pilgrim and the non-pilgrim. So doing a lot of dhikr, like the tahmid, saying alhamdulillah, the takbir, Allahu Akbar, the tahleel, la ilaha illallah. The companions like Ibn Umar and Abu Huraira would go into the market areas and, you know, the public areas, and they would do takbir, you know, Allahu Akbar, Allahu Akbar, Allahu Akbar, la ilaha illallah, wallahu akbar, Allahu Akbar, walillahi alhamd. These are the khair, the season of goodness. It doesn't come every time. It's a golden opportunity for us. The other time is the other deeds, brothers and sisters, also fasting and having the intention that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will reward you. Now, sadaqah from the salaf, some of the salaf would pay sadaqah, or would give sadaqah after every single salah in these 10 days. You know which one is accepted, they would pay sadaqah after every salah. And with that short reminder, brothers and sisters, we also remind ourselves that for those who are intending to do the sacrifice on the 10th of Dhul-Hijjah, which is the day of Eid, there is a hadith that says that one should not remove their nails or hair, any part of their body hair, and the nails, for the person who is intending to do the sacrifice. And this person is the person who is responsible of the household. For example, it would be the father, responsible of the household. So he would he is forbidden from him that he cuts his nails and hair. So there is a khilaf between the scholars. Is this command, is this nahi something that is completely haram? Is it haram to cut your hairs or nails? And Abu Hanifa and Malik say that it's permissible. The person can still cut their hair and nail with their dalil. And Ahmed and Ishaq, Imam Ahmed and Imam Ishaq ibn Rahuya, they are of the opinion that it is haram to cut their hair and nails, and whoever does so will committed a sin. And Imam Shafi'i says that no, it's just disliked. But then, brothers and sisters, so that we be on the safe side and we get out of the khilaf of the scholars, al-ahwat is that the person who is intending, inshallah, to do the sacrifice, he doesn't remove his nails and his nails or hair, but keep your hygiene, look good, alhamdulillah, and keep your hygiene. And that's the last point we want to touch upon. We pray that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala raises this disease from us. And we pray that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala cures the sick. We pray that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala have mercy on those who passed away. We pray that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala accept from us our deeds. Hada wallahu a'lam wa sallallahu wa sallam ala nabina Muhammad.